Howdy, folks. I guess welcome to Don in the Shop. I recently discovered, combined some ideas for fishing a fluke-style bait. This nice bass was caught on a Rudie Rig. She just came up and pow, hammered that thing. And I'm pretty sure I'm not getting ahead of myself to say that this is going to be a very effective way to employ flukes. Had flukes and fluky style baits for years. Never really used them that much. It's the old thing, well, I don't know, those things don't look like they're going to catch anything. Well, they do. What I did was combine a couple of ideas, and I will explain those ideas when we snuggle up here a little closer and I show you what we got going on. And then we'll actually build one of these rigs that I'm calling the Rudie Rig. Thank you, Rudie, for the inspiration. Let's turn the camera around, come over here to the workbench, and I'll show you what I've been working on. As most anglers know, flukes have been around a long time. There's a lot of companies that make them. As a Z-Man fan, I've recently been working with the Z-Man fluke family because they're made out of, well, you guessed it, that indestructible ElaZtech stuff. It's a little harder to work with sometimes, but you can fish it all day long. Don't have to worry about biting the tail off or anything like that. A lot of the Rudie rigs I'll be fishing in upcoming shows come from the scented jerk shad family. The pearl, there's a green lantern, and these last two are the bad shads. Both 4-inch and 5-inch. If you're not a fan of scented fluke-style baits, the Z-Man streaks are pretty cool. They come in different sizes, too. Here's a 5-inch one in pearl. As you can see, it has the same exact profile. The belly slit and all that. Just no scent. Be sure to check out the Z-Man website for your favorite color. And when a fish comes up and grabs a Rudie rig like so, guess what? It gets a face full of treble hook. And on the 5-inch variety flukes, I'm using a number 4 treble hook. Doesn't make any difference what kind you use. And on the little 4-inch ones, I'm using a 6. Okay, here's the real reason we're out here today. It's because I missed my buddy Rudie. And when that happens, I've got no other choice but to throw a Rudie rig. So here's the best Rudie rig fish of the day. Put that tail down. Comes in at 15 and about 3/4. Rudie rig, you are the real deal, buddy. Components of the Rudie rig are actually quite simple, and I got the original idea for this rig from the Inurig with the worm and the coffee straw thing. And the way the coffee stir straw is inserted into the Inurig is what resulted in the Rudie rig. Main components are the fluke. This one here is a Streaks by Z-Man, watermelon red color. I use 12-pound fluoro for the leader, some super glue, either a size 4 or 6 treble hook based upon the size of the lure. A glass bead, clear, and a little red one. I'll talk about that later. A swivel and a pair of scissors and a straw. Let's make one. And ElaZtech does not like anything pushed through it. So I'm going to use a little nail, and I'm going to go in through the nose at an angle, see? And make sure that it comes out at the right place. By trial and error, I learned this trick. If I take my straw and put it right at the end of the nail like so, and then use the straw to push the nail back up and out of the hole, well, guess what? Now the straw is in the right place, see? So I'm going to push the straw up just a little bit, apply some super glue to that area right there, and then pull this down like so. It only takes a little dollop of super glue. Put it right on the straw like so. Pull the straw down to about right there. You can always trim it off later on. And then just set this aside to dry. And then go underneath here, like so. And I'm going to cut this at an angle. Just a slight angle, like so. All right, and that will go back in there. Now I'll take my 12-pound leader and run it through the straw and the nose. Sometimes I'll put a little red bead between the hook and the straw, and this might catch a fish's attention. But since this is already watermelon red, I'm not going to put one in there this time. So I'll just tie this hook on here. I used a palomar knot to tie the hook. And now I'm just going to bring the hook up to the belly of the fluke. And you'll notice on a treble hook, there's always going to be a top hook. And you want that top hook to go into the slot. Okay? Like so, see? And now the two bottom hooks just sit there, waiting for that fish to come up and grab it from the side. It's fairly weedless with just those two little hook points protruding. Almost done. And a clear bead is more than enough weight. And then at the end here, I'm going to go ahead and tie on a barrel swivel. And eventually I'll just attach the barrel swivel to the main line, see? And there it is. That is a complete Rudie Rig. Ready to be tied on and fished. Throw it out, let the little glass bead drag it down just a little bit. Twitch, twitch, twitch over the surface of hydrilla. There's not too many weed, just let it fall all the way to the bottom. So the lure is just going to float around down there, see? I am prognosticating that these Rudie Rigs are going to really work good. Slightly modified Rudie Rig. Looks like it should work. The old treble hook and the tongue trick. All right, I'll tell you, Mama. This is a perfect perch for her. I don't think you're that fish's mother. You're more like, oh, little sister, little brother. Well, they're hitting it pretty hard. I'm throwing right over next to the bank, about 6 feet out, letting it sink, jerk, jerk, stop, and then pow. That's usually what's going on. All right, grow up. Sometimes after the first couple of twitches, as it's sinking, I don't feel anything, and all of a sudden I go, uh-oh, there's something on there, because it feels a little heavier. Yeah, there you go, there you go. Not too bad, just like so.
have a wonderful day. See ya. This is very reminiscent of jerkbait fishing, where you don't do a whole lot. You just let the fish come up and take a look at it. See that? He came up and banged the snot out of that one, didn't he? Ooh, this is a good one. Oops, coming off the drag. Come on now, let's get this one in. This is a nice fish, really nice. Please do not get off, please. Well, no wonder it's such a nice bass. Yeah, you just couldn't stand that, could you? Holy cow. Well, one thing's for sure, this time of the year, they are absolutely beautiful. Okay, I've been trying to drop my lure right out in about this area, right in front of all this leftover weeds and goop here on the bank, and then letting it sink down and twitch, twitch, twitching it out. And this big fellow was probably just cruising around like they typically do. That's a nice, big, handsome catfish, that's for sure. Comes in at easily 23, a little over. I don't know how you measure catfish. Probably about the same as a bass. It's a little over 23. And quite well behaved at the moment. What you looking at? Okay, he has just been chomping down on my fingers like an alligator. Jiminy Christmas. Oh my gosh. Ultra sharp. Very strong teeth and jaws like a pterodactyl. All right, one more thing to do. Get your picture and then we'll let you go. And I've got some ideas for exactly what this color is going to work this spring. And I'm also going to use some of the other Rudie Rigs in a couple of other places this fall.